Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue Eden Streak. Here, the Binding of Isaac Invicta Repentance series. I am back on the main computer, back on the Eden Streak. It feels good, man. Thank you all very much for all the support during the last couple of days when I didn't have the computer and we were playing the Tainted characters. I know a lot of people are excited. A lot of people submitted feedback about that. I do have some ideas for some themed days coming up, which I'll talk about a little bit later on this week. But right now, I'm just excited to be back on Eden. And again, I want to say thank you all very much for the continued support on the like streak as well, as now we're at 6, heading on into all random week. We're well on our way on the brand new like streak as well. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Izzy Burr. Once again, title of the thread was when you thought that it only applies to Isaac. Yes, for those of you who have not seen the Diablo 2 Resurrected series on the Synvicta Gaming channel, definitely go check that one out and you'll see exactly what Izzy Burr is talking about. Thank you, Izzy Burr, and all 157 of y'all that upvoted that one. So here we go, win number one, Hundo. Back, it feels good. Can't possibly lose this one, right? Right? Lima 6-4, Mike Sierra, Tango Lima, November. We've got Doctor's Remote and Jawbone. Decent stats here. Pretty bad movement speed, but our damage is okay. Tears rate's kind of below average, but, you know, that's we're used to below average tears rate by now. No curse? No curse. All right. So I'm sure that some of you have seen by now that I was actually out of town this week. This weekend, I should say. I took a day trip to Boston, of all places, to go see the Patriots versus the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And I went with Bear Taffy. We had a great time. And the game was fun. But let me tell you something. The after game stuff, oh, my gosh. It was probably one of the hardest nights that I've ever had. It took us, I'll spare you the boredom, but just know that it took us about 5 hours to get from the game, from like the stadium to our hotel. And it was a 5 hour ordeal with like at least 10 miles of walking and like the drenched, like freezing rain of, it wasn't freezing, but I mean, it was cold of New England. I mean, it was awful. I'm just going to be honest. It was awful. There's like absolutely no organization in terms of like for people to get like rides or anything like that for taxis or Ubers or Lyfts or anything. there was hundreds of people just all doing the same thing, just looking for rides and stuff at the stadium. And it was bad. I'm sure Bear and I will elaborate on it a lot more on the Three Guys and the Bear Talk About Football podcast with Bear and myself, Coach Crendor and Rob, aka Alpaca Patrol. My God. But you know, it was my first time in the Northeast, and or at least that far Northeast anyway, and it was cool. I mean, I definitely had the best ever clam chowder that I've ever had, period. And I'm not even like a huge clam chowder fan, but oh my gosh, that New England clam chowder was amazing. So, but I'm definitely fully expecting to get sick again, from the Backstreet Boys reunion tour, but from we were just fully exposed to the elements. We had absolutely zero. Okay, I don't know how that didn't. I must not have placed it far anyway. I didn't think it was going to be cold up there. And you know, some people, those of you who live up there, you may be like, wow, what an idiot. But like it was supposed to be 60. Like I was like, oh man, like I'm going from 90 degrees to 60. This is going to be great. How bad could it suck? I'm looking forward to cool weather. But it was much colder than 60, especially when you threw in the freezing rain and everything out there. So I say freezing, but when I say freezing, I don't mean literally freezing. I mean cold. It was very cold. So luckily I did bring a sweatshirt, but I mean I wasn't intending on getting like a 10 mile hike in the rain, you know, wearing wet clothes, and it was just awful, man. So that was the low light of the week, and then I came back literally today, as in Monday. So, but I wanted to make sure that there was just a seamless, You know, no one was of the wiser. The content didn't change at all. You know, we had a fun Tainted Forgotten run. I actually recorded, spoiler alert, I actually recorded that one on Saturday. You know, Tainted Forgotten's always fun. I mean, like most of, I'm not going to say all of them, but most of the Tainted characters are always, you know, a lot of fun. And, you know, people have been sending a lot of spirited responses to the idea of themed weeks. And I think that, I think it's a good idea. Like themed days, like Tainted Tuesday. Someone made a recommendation of that. Where we play a random tainted character, or maybe one of by choosing. I really don't want to do like a random tainted character necessarily, because obviously, like if we get Tainted Lost or Tainted Jacob, or even Tainted Lazarus, like we're gonna have a bad time. I mean, I know people really want to see those characters. I know that people really want to see me play those characters, but I don't want to play those characters because they're just not fun. And you know, I think what's problematic there is that whenever, I don't mind a challenge in Isaac, but when something is not fun in Isaac, it really bleeds through. I mean, yeah, you can just tell that I'm just not in a good mood if Isaac's pulling some BS, or if I'm like playing a character that I absolutely hate. So we'll fine tune that is the best way I'll say that. But overall, people have really been digging the Tainted Res. I've enjoyed playing them. I really have been. I guess I technically didn't need to do that. Wheel of Fortune, I really don't want to risk getting re-rolled here. I like our start. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of Jawbone, but you know, Small Rock and Doctor's Remote's real good. I wish I had it with for the boss fight, but c'est la vie. Yeah, it was I had a great time going to Gillette Stadium, for the game at least. Leaving Gillette Stadium was a whole nother matter, as we just got to talking about. Buccaneers did win. You know, they played pretty bad, I think. In my opinion, they played pretty awful. But it was cool. The whole reason why Bear and I wanted to go was A, to see Tom play, and B, to see him break the record, which he did in very unceremonious fashion. But he did do it. Get bad PH Dizzle. I mean, our movement speed's already so bad, man. We gained damage and lost luck. I think there's another. I think we left another card over here, or another pill over here. See what this pill is. Health down. Damage up. So bad PH Dizzle is going to give us one negative effect, but also give us a positive effect. Some people really like bad PHD. I think it can be good, especially if you have stats to spare. This is not a run that we have a whole lot of stats to spare, except our damage now, I guess, technically. There it is. Pills, no effect. All right. Fantastic. Glad we came all the way over here for that. So Small Rock killed our movement speed. Our tears rate is slightly improved, obviously, but we need something a little bit juicier. We can use our only key. That's kind of what I was afraid of. I wouldn't mind getting Diplopia if we could. We are not going to be able to. Okay, so yeah, see, like this is the problem with that PhD right here, is that we shouldn't know what this pill is at all. So I'm going to buy it just out of the honor system, but I'm not going to use it because obviously it's an addicted pill. But we shouldn't have been able to see what pill that is, and that's the problem that I've always had with the mod. And before you say anything, no, we haven't seen that pill yet. And you can config it to where it doesn't do that for cards and stuff, but it still identifies pills. Unless they've changed it since the last time I looked at the menu, which has been admittedly a little while now. We pretty much have to do this here. But it was interesting talking to Patriots fans, and now we were wondering, like, without exaggeration, there was probably 200 people waiting for Ubers and Lyfts and taxis, and there was no cars. And we were talking to some local Patriot fans. We're like, is this normal? They're like, yeah, it's usually kind of a mess on Sunday games, on like night games, but never this bad. I mean, we were there for 3 hours at the stadium, and there were still cars leaving. Like, that was madness to me. I'm used to seeing way more organization. So, but again, if you want to hear the full story with full details, then you know, go check out tonight. We record it today, but it won't be out till probably Wednesday, whenever Crendor decides to put it out. Go subscribe to us, though. And definitely traveling there was no problem on the, like, on the planes and stuff. You know, I'm not a bad flyer. I don't mind traveling. I just hate traveling. Like, I hate sitting on a plane doing absolutely nothing, making small talk with people you don't know, or just being friendly and stuff. But it's like, you know, you're just kind of sitting there, like, and the Wi-Fi is not very good, so you can't even stream, like, videos or streams or whatnot. Which I know sounds like a first world problem, but it's kind of like, I mean, come on, like, what else are we gonna do? Like, you know, I'm not gonna bring my Switch. Like, that's what Bear did. He was like, "Did you bring your Switch?" I was like, "No, I didn't even think about doing that," because I'm like, I don't know. I don't. The first thing I think of when I fly is not like, "Oh man, let me bring my Switch." You know, I'm like, yeah, I'll just watch a movie or something like that. But like, the act of traveling and flying and, like, getting through security, or whatever, was really no big deal at all. And it, you know, there's no security delays or anything like that. So it wasn't an unpleasant experience traveling. Wow, we are getting shut out on these secret rooms. We are getting a ton of soul hearts, though. I'm not sure why, but I ain't gonna complain about it, though. Gotta get one more full charge here before we go fight the boss. I will say it's definitely interesting, in a not great way, traveling during the Backstreet Boys reunion tour. It definitely changed a lot, for sure. Since the last time that I actually traveled on an airplane was pre Backstreet Boys time to now, things definitely have changed a lot. And, you know, keeping the masks on and everything was very annoying. Not that I'm against wearing masks, but I mean, I did not enjoy a 4-hour flight of having to wear a mask all the time. It was like, ugh. You know, after a while, it gets old. That was a perfect jump by Mega Fatty. But we have, I mean, there's HP to spare, so you never want to take damage, but I mean, it's negligible damage. Constellation Prize is going to give us some movement speed. And we do get a Yave, so we can get a premium item out of the store. But we're going to have to get either a bomb or a full charge on our doctor's remote to get a champion belt. Which, assuming there's enemies over here, we can do. Which, assuming there's enemies over here, we can do. Assuming there's enemies over here, we can do. There we go. I think that needles are very quickly becoming my most hated enemy in the game. I know everyone's like, "Oh, they're cute, they're mini pins, by God." And yeah, it's like, yeah, that's it, but the frequency that they spawn underneath Isaac or right next to you and block you from moving is pushing my buttons, grinding my gears, and I just don't like them. I somehow missed the keeper there, but we're going to get the champion belt, and let's try that again here, Isaac. There we go. I will buy this key just because we don't have any more. So not a great floor for us, but we do get champion belt. So, I mean, our damage is starting to look up. I may have accidentally missed a pill or something. Not on this floor, but maybe the last one. Curse of the Lost. We get a full charge in the... We can use in that previous room to get, you know, a chance of getting something like Magic Mush. Would be nice. Definitely wouldn't mind getting more movement speed here, but our tiers rate is our biggest downfall currently. And that's the problem with bad PhD, is just that, like, you can't always rely on it giving you the stat that you need. Most of the time, it's going to give you damage ups in exchange for other stats. Golden Key is nice here. Okay, we almost got all of them down there. I'm not going to go fight the boss yet because we need to find, or at least I want to find the shop so we can get the keeper down. Yeah, I don't like him. Don't like him one bit. Flying V formation here. Now we could just bomb that keeper. Still rather go for the shop though. Movement speed. If we get blood bag here, that would be amazing. Use that one time too late, but that's okay. In before comment. Does Invicta know that you can go down to empty heart containers? Cheeky shot there from the purple champion. Yeah, let's get the hell out of this room. How about that? That sounds like a good idea. You Jawbone. Jawbone doing a good job at just, you know, picking stuff up for us, and your efforts are appreciated on this organization. I like the hustle. I like the synergies that you got going on with, you know, all these spawns in the rooms and whatnot. Coaches have been seeing it, don't worry. Taking notes. And still looking for that shop. I think we've gone everywhere but the item room and the shop, which means that they're going to be adjacent to one another. Take the black rune here. I guess I didn't really have to do that with the Jawbone. I keep forgetting that. Like, I'm so used to being in autopilot for navigating on like, oh, an item dropped. Let me just go pick this up real quick, you know? But the Jawbone can literally pick that up without any risk, and I'm just like, I'm gonna step through the spikes. I'm some victor. Shot speed down for a damage up, most likely. Or tears up. That'd be nice. Yeah, it's damage up. We're finally starting to get somewhere with our bombs and keys here. And this floor just keeps on going. Excuse me. Thank you. Got to turn off the console commands once again. This is from, this had to have been from the, what, previous Thusmas. The before times of old stuttery making its return. I will take Tech 1. I don't think Tech 1 is necessarily... I mean, Tech 1's great. Don't get me wrong. But it's not necessarily a game changer currently. I mean, I love having the piercing shots and the unlimited range for sure. But we needed to get something spicier in terms of either tiers rate or just extreme amounts of damage. Tech 1 is very good, and it's one of my favorite items. And it's massively improved in Repentance. Thought this is where we came from. Apparently not. But we really need Tears Rate for it to shine. Even, I mean, I'm not saying I would take Movement Speed over Tech 1, but like even Movement Speed would be good here. So let us take down the boss here in Flooded Caves 2. Hopefully we get ourselves an easy one-shotable boss with Doctor's Remote, which, I mean, Ragmega is pretty easily one-shottable. There he goes. Saw the Sad Bombs effect there from Tech 1. Marrow is black runable for show. And not feeling this devil deal either. Perthrow. We will use the Perthrow rune once this Demon Judgment pays out. I mean, I'll use it once to get the damage up and orbital. Use the Perthrow rune here. And we get Azazel's Rage. I will take Lord of the Pit. The Nail. I'm going to take it because we have this black rune. I'm actually not going to take Azazel's Rage. I honestly don't think it's that great. It doesn't last as long as I'd like to. Plus, we have a double item pedestal here that we can use the black rune on. And we didn't get a tears up. Yeah, buddy. Rolling like a big shot. This is our movement speed after getting Lord of the Pit, which is still pretty slow. Definitely use some of those soul hearts that we left on the other floor back now. But Marrow just gives us a bone heart, and bone hearts are honestly, they're good for defense. Especially if you have the damage to protect it for a while. You shouldn't be really losing a bone heart almost ever. Unless, of course, you get like champion double tapped or something like that. Yeah, so that's basically our entry into the curse room if we find one. Line them up and then go over the little gap here. We're going to end up using the nail in this room because it gives us the stompy effect, and we might as well get a sun card here.
The sun.
There we go. All right. We came back from the brink. Although I really should have left those soul hearts until after I had gone to the curse room here. I didn't think about that. That's me acting a little bit too quickly. Absolutely, we'll take the mark. And it's going to give us the Leviathan transformation as well. And now we're starting to really pick up here. This is that big power spike that we wanted. And now we're going to see Tech One really, really started to take off. The Horf. Yeah, we use Horf. Might as well go check out the mob trap room while we're here. Yeah. Okay, all right. Getting our movement speed up to good levels now. I'm liking it. Oh, I just gotta do something about this gosh dang old tears raid. I'm gonna take a hit just to save time, although it may kill him. No, it didn't. Okay. I know it was the last wave, but I'm lazy. Let's use Horf to get into the secret room. We'll take Tarot Cloth as well. That, look at that. We get a Hierophant card. Beautiful. That's the dream combo right there. World card. What do you do with the Tarot Cloth? Forget. Nothing. All right. Fair enough. We could play this Demon Judgment. Let's wait to see what we get from the boss and from the Devil Deal as well. Assuming we get one. Demon baby here. Or not demon baby, rotten baby. Okay, so we will have a nail buff for the boss. Which I'm fully expecting to be Gish at this point. Really? Be surprised by that. Get me cage gonna go down pretty easily. Another move speed up, and we get Guppy's Eye, Sanguine Bond. So take the eye. Yeah, I don't like Sanguine Bond. So how hard do we go on this Demon Judgment now? With one Guppy item, I think we can risk it. Adrenaline not gonna give us too much of a boost there, but is what it is. So we're looking fairly good here now. We head on down to Depths 2. First the unknown. It's okay. As long as we have some kind of HP generator, even if it's a half soul heart. With this amount of damage and mobility, we should be able to protect it, no problem. Keyword is should. Whether or not we will or not, that's completely different. Vanishing Twins is going to give us a second boss that will spawn. And it's really only going to be good for one fight, and that's in the womb. Down. Damage up. Still looking for our tears up. Still want them tears ups. Good for half of a heart. Might as well. You know what? Give me Keeper's Box. Alright, fantastic. No, I can't be there. What are you doing? Although we did get two tarot cards, and that could be HP. But we did get a full card. Okay. We missed boss rush by about 6 minutes. So I don't think it's gonna be useful on this run. Will we do a victory lap for run number 100? It's a tall order, man. That's pretty dangerous. We're looking okay right now, but with this tears rate or lack thereof, I don't know. Let's see if we get a double deal here. I'd love to get back in the triple digits. See that win column go to where we all know and have seen it for the majority of the time here on the channel. Spent a lot more time in the triple digits than we did the quadruple digits, that's for sure. Very active blue mom. We didn't get it, but we're going to do it anyway. Come on now. Come on now. Not a good start. Thank you very much. Jawbone. I just saw a fly through across my field of vision. Not sure if I got him or not. Got pills, no effect. And you're seeing how important it is to just have that HP generator every time we get that full charge. Even if it's just one half soul heart, it's good enough to keep you afloat. Anarchist Cookbook, we'll touch it for the Bookworm Transformation possibility. Okay, 2 of 3 of spun. So we'll go maybe check this way as the right way to go. Yeah, I mean, the idea of themed days, you know, really does work in theory. The only time it doesn't is here's my concern. My concern is that I'm going to forget about a particular theme day. Like if we say like Wacky Wednesday, like I used to do for GeoGuessr. And then like I get to the next Wednesday, or if I'm just having an off day and I just forget and I'm just like, you know, going through the motions of doing a regular run, you know, that's going to really throw off the vibe of the run or something, you know, cause people are like, oh, I expected, Tainted Tuesday. And then we end up, and then I somehow forget and just stop, you know, I just decided to do a run without even thinking. So I'm cognizant of making sure that people are seeing what they want to see here on the channel and are having a good time doing it. So their Vanishing Twin's going to give us 2 conquests. We finally get a tears up here. Thank you to Vanishing Twin. Great dodge. I'm not even going to lie. That was good. A Dark Bomb, which is going to give us some passive HP generation. Broken Heart, I don't know about. I think I'm good on that. We'll take Dark Bomb, though. D-Bizzle, let's go. There are some red hearts here that we can pick up along the way. Go. As long as we get one of them off of this floor, you know, that makes the backtracking all the worthwhile. Well, there it is. E-Bizzle, look at that. There we go. That's what I'm talking about, son. I don't have to give you a scolding now after that first spider payout. Trust me, it was coming. It was coming for you. So I did get the computer back, as I said, and found out the reason why that pumps kept going bad on the Origin PC. And the reasoning behind it, this is something that I never even would have expected. So they were able to fix the computer, obviously, and I moved away from the closed loop that Origin had installed on this computer because I'm tired of dealing with these pump issues. And we found out, the tech who was working on it let me know, informed me that Origin PC made this closed loop system, the one that they built, with two radiators, and one pump. I know that sounds like a meme, but I'm telling you. So I was like, excuse me? So they're making one singular pump made, designed as a one-to-one, you know, one radiator, one pump. They put it on a closed loop system with two radiators, full-size radiators. So it's no wonder that the pumps were killing themselves, because, you know, they weren't designed to do that. It's one pump, one radiator. That's it, you know. And by pump, I mean the water pump. For the coolant. So I was like, man, that surprised me, but it didn't surprise me. Does that make sense? So I don't know why Origin did that. There's literally no reason to have two radiators with one pump. That, at least if you can do two radiators and one pump, that's fine, but make sure the pump is good enough to be able to get water through, because that was the problem this time around, was that there was not enough water getting through and cooling the CPU, which for some reason people thought it was the GPU. I don't know why, because I mentioned that I was playing New World and people automatically assumed that the GPU was burned out. Not true at all. It was the CPU. But that's beside the point. So we got I just put a basically an all-in-one, an AIO system in there for cooling, and it's running, you know, it's running great. Hopefully it's the last time I have to deal with it for a while, and we can get back to, you know, our usually regularly scheduled programming here. Gabo, and I was really hoping that you're gonna be back. There you go. I deal with the devil 36%, and we'll head on to zone. Now, there might be some members of the mosh pit who are more technically inclined than I am. I mean, I did used to be a tech, so like I know a fair bit about stuff. I don't know of, at least not in my memory banks. I don't know of any reason why you would ever do that, to put two radiators on one pump, unless they know something that I don't know. But I've never heard that before. I've never built one in any of the systems that I've had, that I've built with water cooling. To me, it just doesn't make any gosh dang sense, because you're just asking for burned out radiators. I mean, it's curse the blind, but can't be too bad in here. Now we could theoretically play the sacrifice room to maybe get another angel deal item, or an angel deal item, or devil deal item. That can happen, but against Stanley, and we're doing a victory lap. I don't know, man. You can get teleported to the victory lap, but like we're about to go there anyway, so I wanted to do that because I wanted to get the nail for this fight. Gonna be a doozy. Here we go. Good snipe there by Rotten Baby. It was a great, great play. The last stomp, we're going to get hit. We don't want to open any of these. Oh, we can go get our fool card. Let's get our fool card. So just in case if we run into a dead end or like a big dead end, we can at least get out of there. Taking blue fires really quickly. See if they pay out with soul hearts. Not going to happen. And we'll head on down to the dark chest on lap number one here. Headed towards win number 100. Curse the Unknown, we get Sack Dagger, Money Equals Power, Lusty Blood. Definitely going to go Lusty Blood here. Money Equals Power is a lot of, that's a lot of damage as well. So, but we really got to be careful here with our HP now. With this being Curse the Unknown, I mean, that's a pretty risky move. Let's not get two super prides, thanks. We had 9 lives, is going to be our second Guppy item. And this is just going to be one big old dead end, so I'm just going to use that. All right. 9 lives, definitely going to help us out here. We're getting some, again, I feel like we need to get a street counter of just how many times we've gone to the dark chest and just getting some of the worst rooms you can get. Skinny, the narrow dark one room, the double fistula room, you know, the double super pride room is really, really bad. The triple super sloth, like what's going on here? I mean, I know that we have champion belt, but like, man, this is rough here. All right, Dark Bum, we're gonna need your help, sir. Double Black Death. I mean, these are gnarly, gnarly rooms. It's where the lack of tears rate really starts to become a factor. Almost even more so than lack of HP. I think Jawbone deflected that. Into the ultra secret room, which is gonna give us Miter. Oh, okay. So hopefully Miter is going to help us out a little bit. But now you got to second guess going so hard there on that beginning devil deal of this floor. Once again, we get one of these jerks. It's our third one. Oh, and then we just get, you know, 6 champion polycephaluses. This might be one of the hardest dark chests I've ever seen. Yeah, that's insane right there. Dark Bomb, we need some help. Got the at the Black Soul Heart. There we go. That's what we want to see. What the? Okay. Let's clear one more room here just so we get the damage upgrade and a little bit of extra HP. Good old champion brownie. All right. So again, we have no idea how much HP we have. We have to assume we've got probably 1.5 soul hearts. And I was right. I mean, those shots are just so floaty. That trick only works once. Great block by Wishbone there. Let Bob's curse just do the work here on Lamb. Yeah, what's the big deal? All right, second run, making us earn it. Charlie 6, Juliet 3, Hotel Golf, Lima Romeo. Making us earn it. We get our found soul back, which gives us the double shot here. Oh, yeah. Well, we already have the moon card, so. Definitely would love to get Incubus. This shows you what we're missing here with a decent amount of, at least, follies. As in, like, you know, shot follies. We're still only on 1 HP, so we got to be a little bit cautious, but we're not, I mean, we're not going to see anything harder than the Lamb. We get Soul of King, Soul of Cain, actually, which maybe. That's half soul heart. Very nice. Nope. Soul of Cain will just use the red key, and it opens any available red doors. Which is always very helpful whenever you know how to find the ultra secret rooms. Oh yeah, we have Vanishing Twin. That's going to be real nice because we get double items here to choose from. And... we're going to go with Old Bandage, because obviously we don't need the range upgrade. Oh, there's a Soul of Eden. Wish I would have seen that. All right, well, we'll save it for the next boss room, because we're guaranteed, thanks to us getting options on this floor, we're guaranteed to get 4 items at least from every single boss. And that is what we like to call muy bueno. Justice card here. 2 of clubs. No! Waiting for that mod, man. Waiting for that locks your consumable slot mod. What I was trying to do is I was obviously going to use the Justice card and then use the Two of Clubs, but not happen that way. You know, Money Was Power just giving us more and more damage. Still really hoping that we get some more tiers up. Would be nice. Yeah, I guess we can take God's Flesh. Doesn't really do much. I mean, it gives you the shrinking tiers. Ooh. Dice Baggerino. The D10. Gonna reroll the enemies into something else. Sometimes worth it, sometimes not. The D fizzle. I don't really want to reroll this run. Or do I? I don't. They were only one away from Guppy. Again, I don't want to reroll this run. Not yet. Not unless we can hold on to Guppy. And I like Tech 1, man. I think Tech 1 is real good. I shan't be doing it, game. I would like a D6 in here, though. Hey, Eternal D6. Yeah, that'll work out, right? 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 Yeah, kind of. We're going to get spun here. I will take the world card. We have starter deck anyway, so we get Judas's freaking shadow. Which, honestly, I think the Judas's shadow is going to be completely useless. But I'll take it anyway. We will head on. Want to go... What do you want to do? Want to fight Mother? I don't want to fight Old Beastie. Let's go fight Old Beastie. Old Beastie. That's a teleportation to the Devil Deal. We know that because if you look at the... What does this do? Is that... Aids. If you look at the chest with Guppy's eye and you don't see anything in there, that means it's a teleport. Because Guppy's eye is supposed to show you everything. Ooh, we get the Soul of Isaac. Okay. Going on right now. Nice bag. You're screwing up a lot of stuff here. So what I was trying to do was use the Soul of Isaac on the Devil Deal. Although I'm pretty sure that it doesn't work like that anyway. So maybe that was just things working out for the best. Happy that we at least got a tears up here thanks to Spun and from the Screw. There's the D1. What D1? Why don't you come over here for a second? How about you give me two of them? Okay, thanks. Yeah, the shrinking effect that you saw was God's flesh. It's usually kind of risky to try to stomp over a champion because they can do retaliatory effects that do not get broken by God's flesh, so you could be inadvertently walking your way to disaster. You gotta be careful with that. You don't want to pick up the charge key yet because we're about to get a full charge in here. Now we can go in here and pick up this charge key. Go check out our greed fight, possibly. Oh, no greed fight. Battery pack's going to give us a whole bunch of, half of soul hearts anyway. Devil card. That was a massive tears up there. This is what we're talking about. Born photo is going to get us to 4.46 attacks per second. And that's where you want to be with tech. And tech one is going to be really starting to take off now. And it's looking like all systems go for win number 100. Another tiers up here, and that's another. No, it's not another tiers up. Let's wait on that. We still have the soul of Isaac. Oh yeah, there's a soul of Isaac on this, and don't know if these do anything. I'm just gonna take blood clot. Yeah, we'll take blood clot, and sure, we'll go down. We'll go down to Ash Pit, not to get the key, but just to change it up and get a little extra item or two. Possibly. Yeah, now you're seeing that tech one shine with this tears rate. I mean, when your tech one starts to look like tech two, that's where you want to be. And again, you see here with the unlimited range, this is so good. Picking off stuff. You get a de-sizzle, but unfortunately it's temporary. Dry baby! Get another tears up here from the rosary. But I hope everyone's Tuesdays have been going awesome for you. Looking forward to recording the podcast. Me and Bear will be sharing our experience over at Gillette Stadium. It was very, it's so fun. Oh, okay. How is this going to work? Are they just going to accelerate each other's death? Or is it just bug now? So, yeah. That's a good one there, Repentance. So we are soft locked. Let's see if this will do anything. Yeah, so I don't know what we're gonna do about that. So that's fun. Really, really good thing to put an exclamation point on this. So now what we're going to have to do, we're going to have to get a reroll dice, or ultimately I'm going to have to get rid of Vanishing Twin just for this floor with the debug console. Neither one is ideal because I hate when the game does this and it forces me to have to do this kind of thing, but I mean, what else can we do? It's either that or we just say, oh, well, I guess we just lose. We could also go to the sacrifice room and skip this. But word to the wise, don't ever take Vanishing Twin if you're going alt path, basically. So our only option now is, I think, to go... We're going to have to go to the dark chest again, which means that we're going to also be forced to lose an item because we're going to be doing the second victory lap now. So yeah, I'm pretty happy about all this stuff. You know, it's super awesome when this kind of thing happens, you know. So it was a great time. Certainly not frustrating at all. Bro, it's a 50-50. We get Horror Babylon. Let me get down, which does give us Bookworm. Okay, so we'll take Let Me Get Down for Bookworm. Then I will also take... I'll take Death's Touch for the damage. We don't care about the tears down. All right. So here we are once again. Wasn't expecting to have to do this, but hey, I guess it's better than using the developer console, but you know, I'm not opposed to that at this point, because like you got to be honest. I mean, Repentance is buggy. As buggy as all get out. You know, there's all kinds of soft locks and stuff that I don't think it's fair for the game to be able to just say, you know, haha, I win because I can soft lock you, sort of thing. Like that's not fun for anybody. We go down to Horror Babylon State thanks to accidentally running into that temperance machine. We do get a de-sizzle. But obviously, that's something that I try to avoid doing at all costs, just because it really does ruin the spirit of the run. But again at the same time, I'm not going to let the game get one over on me. We're not going to lose. Okay, Guppy off of double dead cat. We're not going to lose a run, especially win number 100, because the game just soft locks. There's no way I'm going to let that happen. Use the Empress card here. We did get Guppy, so again, our damage will be quite nice. But, yeah, we can see how many items we lose on the victory lap. So we immediately lost Vanishing Twin, which was one of the ones I was really happy about. We also lose, third run, by the way, Delta, Bravo, Papa, Echo, X-Ray, Lima, 9, Delta. We lost almost all of our movement speed, and we lost all of our tiers upgrades. I don't know if... We're still Guppy. Okay, so we didn't lose Guppy. We did lose one of our 9 lives. But losing the tiers upgrades definitely hurts a lot. Still maintain Money Equals Power. Juice is Shadow. We lost Vanishing Twin, which is good, I guess. E1's gonna duplicate the bag. We get a rules card. So here's the hoping we get those tiers rate, or that tiers rate back here, because we were definitely moving. But now we're at the point where it's like, I don't know if we're gonna go fight Beastie. Double pin, by God. By God. Okay, so I definitely want the movement speed here. And Planetarium chance, I actually will take more movement speed. I want my movement speed back, and we just got it back, so it's good. Oh, we also lost the tarot card, or tarot cloth as well. Up dark Bizzle, D Bizzle. Yeah, let's do it. Oh, good God. Oh, we got Pogatory. We did lose Guppy, but we got Black Candida. We got Vanishing Twin back as well. We lost Dark Bum. Don't know if this was a better reroll or not. We did get Cracked Orb and Dreamcatcher. Of course, love seeing Pogatory. We also got Experimental Treatment. If you don't know what happened there, we drew the we got Pay to Play. We drew the D100 from the dice bag. Happy that we have mapping of sorts. But Mysterious Liquid plus Vanishing Twin, or not Vanishing Twin, but Evil Twins, or Evil Pair, I should say, is quite good. Twisted Pair? You know what I'm talking about. Of course, Pogatory, always great to see it. Which is a very different thing than a suppository. I was going to go with a suppository joke there, but then like my brain short-circuited halfway through, and I was like, how am I going to actually say this? It was to limited success, I would say. Some people are saying, no, it wasn't. All right, so we get two spooky, which a lot of people really like. We get Guppy's Paw. We also got another D1 Hizzle, so I mean... Oh yeah, it does that, doesn't it? Oh, we get Dark Bizzle back. We also got Death's List now, a Psyfly, Chaos, and Goathead. The Goathead will at least be able to get back into our shop, or back into the Devil Deal to see exactly what we got from the reroll. And it's Maw of the freaking Void. Sanguine Bond. I'm still not going to take Sanguine Bond. Now we're just getting all wacky with it. Got the D Sizzle in there. Got the D Whizzle. While the Void, you know, it's still a good item. It's just not as good as it used to be. Blah, blah, blah. But Huts and I were talking about it, and we were trying to decide. It was something that the Mosh Pit brought up, which was like, what's the worst nerf of repentance and whatnot? And Huts didn't agree with me that Maw of the Void is the hardest hit, like the biggest nerf. I don't remember what item he said though, but I feel like the Maw of the Void nerf was definitely the biggest one. That was the one that was like, man, that's just sad. Look what they did to my boy. It was one of those type of moments. We got the D4. Let's see what we get in the devil deal first with this chaos card, or this chaos plus Goathead play. Go fight the boss real quick. It's going to be Gertie Jr. Here we go. Get the D8. I don't know about the D8. Debbie's Paw is useful because we can get rid of our red hearts. And we get 9 lives again. We get Guppy again. The third time now. I think we'll hold on to it this time. For now. I was missing our Guppy effect. We do have a great tears right here, thanks to Epiphora. We're going to double back and go check out our item room. Epiphora capping out at almost 11 attacks. 13 attacks, I should say. There's more and more tears ups. They always appear when you just don't need them anymore. That's just how it works. Get our luck upgrade. Check out our Shopperino, and there's Tribadian, which I'm going to be leaving there.
Invicta, you said that you like Trizagian. You wouldn't call it Tribadian anymore.
That doesn't sound like something I would say, necessarily. Necessarily, it's not something I would say. We need that. What's that? We need that that predator gif of Carl Weathers and Arnold Schwarzenegger. You know, Dylan, you son of a, and they're like, you know, they're flexing their biceps, whatever. One of them would be like finding dead ends, and then also hating Trisagion. In the middle is just Sinvicta. Which, I mean, if you really think about it, like, that meme is just an over dramatic Venn diagram, really. You know, it's like when you think about it, like, it's like, well, that's not a very impressive meme. Just a Venn diagram. Killer of memes. It is a good meme, but I mean, you know, if you think about it for half a second, if you think about it for even more than half a second, it's like, man, most memes are like, some of them are like not good. There are some memes that are good, though. Think about what is your of your all-time favorites? All-time favorites. What is your all-time most favorite meme of all time? You can only pick one. I really like the Vince McMahon progression meme. You know what I'm talking about. I really like that one just because I think it has so many practical uses in everyday life. Like, you don't even have to know what that's from or who Vince is to appreciate the hilarity of the facial expressions. That's a sign of a good meme right there. Probably should take the Book of Shadows. There's that big Guppy Maw the Void damage. There we get Cracked Orb again. Chaos has given us Fanny Pack. Thanks, Chaos. And you knew we had to do it up big. Had to do it up big for win number one hundo. Even though it didn't quite go the way that I wanted to, obviously, because of, you know, being forced to do a second victory lap. But still, I mean, we can't have fun. I said the F word.
Skrr.
Oh, good. We got TM Trainer. Okay, and we got hit and then used Genesis? Question mark? Okay, well, first, let me get my HP back. All right. Well, now. Okay. All right. We lost all of our money. We lost everything. We just lost everything. We don't even have the Polaroid anymore. I guess Luckfoot for pills. It's going to be a whole bunch of HP, I guess. Okay. Good. Quality items here. Proptosis. I guess Proptosis. Who would ever thought that we'd be debating that? I'll take the box. Treasure map. Map compass, okay. Duplex. Yeah, brother! I guess more HP. Jelly Belly's real good for defense. And all right, good. I'll take the swarm. I think 120 volts good here, so is Deadeye. Keeper's Kin. Let's extend our range here, multidimensional baby. X-ray vision. Could get 99 bombs here, or just a slight bit of damage. We need some damage, we really do. Any damage is good here. Mulligan or Toxic Shock. We go with Toxic Shock. I will go with a Satanic Bible over Suplex. Sorry, Suplex. And we'll go Quad Shot. Bloody Lust. We have Quad Shot, so $3 bill is not too bad. We'll take 20-20 because, I mean, heck, why not? We get Magic Mush and Sissy! You knew she had to show up, Sissy. Little Sissy. Take Blood of the Martyr here as well. I mean, I want to keep the Satanic Bible, so... Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Tears up, finally. Charm Tears, I guess Camo Undies. Mini Mush for movement speed. Play-Doh Cookie for the lulls of having Quad Shot. I guess we have to take EFF, or we could take Undefined. We'll take the Sad Onion, thank you. Larynx making a return. I think it was Power again, sure. PH Dizzle. Eden's Blessing for the Tears Up. How many shots can we get? How many shots can we get? You know, Lusty Blood. Ghost Pepper. Pisces. Again, more Tears Up. Bloody Gust is going to be good. Piercing Shots. Yeah. Yeah. Compound Fracture. Yeah, we'll take Sad Bombs. We're getting all the bomb effects. We'll take Purity as well. Infestation 2. Inch Nails for show. Fat on Mushroom. Skinny on Mushroom. Parasite, oh god. Pack 2. I think Tech 2 would ruin this. There you go, Dead Bird. Sci-Fly. Welcome back to the team, Sci-Fly. Sulfuric Acid giving us some damage here. It could take Lost Soul, I guess. Got the D-Sizzle or Spin Down die. Take the D-Sizzle. Homing Tears, definitely. Jacob's Ladder. I know that taking Tractor Beam would have been pretty decent there, but... Oh, man. Tiny Planet with this. Take a speed up as well. I don't know how many items we're going to get, but we're just going to keep on going, I guess. I mean, how many items did we have? We must have had quite a few. Range up, speed up. I'll take Blue Map. Mystery Sack. More HP. And, Linger Bean is not too bad. We've already got tons of multi-shots, sure. This is going to crash the game. I can already feel this is going to be a train wreck in every possible way, because we have all the things that make the game crash. Wafer is going to be extremely important. I'll take piercing or poison shots here. Stigmata, cancer. Sure, why not? At this point, why not? Yeah. Okay. Wow. Curious to see if that was a good play or not. There's the toys, very good. Worm buddy. One. Number one's actually in all stats down with Libra. Gotta remember that we have Libra now. Take chocolate milk. We'll take you. Yeah, we'll take shielded tears. I don't know if that's an all stats down or up at this point. Contagion. Yeah, we'll take that one. Sure, we'll take Ice Cube Baby and give me some Epiphora. Why not? Bud Puppy. The D1 Hizzle. Capricorn. Yeah, Capricorn's good. Really have no idea how and why we're getting so many items, but when in Rome. Sacrificial Altar. Ease Mascara is an all stats down, I believe. Look at Belial. There we go. Incubus. I'm pretty sure it's an all stats down. Metal Plate. Yeah, okay. All right. Okay. I'll take Halitosis. Montezuma's Revenge. Speedball. Spooky Bombs, we all saw how much that was awesome. I'm pretty sure that that's an all stats down. That is not an all stats down. It's an all stats up right there. I'm not going to take Amalacria. Go Maggie's Bow. And it immediately crashed. Woo! Win number 100. Now, the question is it going to start us inside of Genesis? I think TM Trainer just gave us every single... I'm pretty sure it just gave us every single item in the game. Where are we? What are we doing? We're back on Depths 1. This is, I think, before the last reroll. I don't know, dude. Let's just end the... Let's just get this run over with at this point. D1 Izzle! TM Trainer! All right. Oh, Jelly Belly going ham there. Okay, yeah. So it was TM Trainer. We basically took damage and we activate Genesis. So we're gonna stay pretty vanilla here at this point. I don't want to take too many. Really, what it comes down to is Jacob's Ladder and any type of splinter shot causes the game to crash. So we cannot take Jacob's Ladder at all. I'm still gonna take Proptosis though. We'll take HP. Treasure map. Here comes the compass. I thought maybe no compass. Okay. No cream? Okay, no cream. We'll take Twisted Pear. Vengeful Spirit, sure, why not? Box, yeah. Take the Swarm. I was really kind of like looking forward to seeing what that run would have looked like, but you know, say repentance be repentance, right? Here's our compass. Yeah, Deadeye. Let's just end it with Mom's Knife. Let's get some HP, call it a day. Just call it a day here. Fanny pack. Quad shot, yeah. Bloody Lust, $3 bill, Twanky Twanky. Using page number 2 says, hey, Pretty Plum, yep. Sulfur, I don't think Sulfur's the right call here. Yeah, we'll take his only friend Beelzebub. Incubus. 9 lives. All the Vizoid. Test list. Ares for movement speed. I want just a little bit of stats. Just a little bit of stats here. Boogie's horns. I'm still going to take Toxic Shock. Probably should have taken Ghost. I forgot what the other one was. Ghost Pepper. Keeper. That. You. Not taking Damocles. Damocles is another good way to crash the game at this point. If we can get some of our movement speed, that would be amazing. Skinny on Mushroom doesn't really do anything for us. We'll take River Cement. Dead Bird. Psyfly. Body. Buddy Gust. Movement speed. I'm going to take the movement speed here. And there's Guppy. Okay. All right. No more. Hey, okay. All right. Okay. Maybe a little bit more of that. Okay. Well, I mean, we got to get Mulligan at least. You know. Yeah, Jelly Belly. We got to. Okay. Horror Babylon's where we'll stop. We'll stop now. We'll stop. But, well, that's a nice tiers upgrade there. Okay. Well, I mean, we got to take Godin. Okay. Now we'll stop. Okay. All right, let's just go. Let's just speed run the rest of this here. We're just gonna fly over to old Beastie. This is still the second victory lap. Just making sure that. Oh my God, look how many knives we have. This might be the most knives I think I've ever seen ever. That wasn't like inside of like a brimstone like beam. Look at that. Talk about your halo of knives, man. Yeah, we don't care. I probably should just use the Hermit card. Yeah, this build turned out to be pretty good, I'd say. And plus, we got a little sissy, you know? We got a little sissy. She's happy to be here. She's happy that the Eden Streak is back. And I'm happy that the PC is fixed. And hopefully the last of our heating... Our overheating issues are a thing of the past now. Hopefully. And if we have any more... Did it crash again? Seriously? Did too many knives hit the target? Oh, yep. There it goes. Oh, boy. No, we're doing... I mean, we're doing it live. This is repentance. Woo. All right. You can't stop me from getting win number 100, game. It's not happening. Not happening. So how, pray tell, are we supposed to get past the deacons here, game? If too many knives are hitting the target... Okay, so we need to make sure that we don't hit the deacons or the priests or whatever the heck they are. We don't hit them with knives if they have anything, or we don't hit their targets, their shielded targets. Otherwise, the game could also crash, apparently. Got it. Comprende. That's a pretty cool cross cut right there. I liked it. Okay. You can be Beelzebub. Oh, we have no keys. We had so many keys during the run, I didn't even realize that we had none. You need to confess your sins and become saved. Let his light inside you cleanse your soul. Okay.
Pray for your
Well, this is going wonderfully. Okay, all right. I'm not going to back down, game. I mean, it's not even like we did anything to break the game. This is what I'll say. I honestly think that TM Trainer should just be removed from the game. It's not because I don't like the item. I actually really like the item, but it causes so many problems in Isaac that it's just not worth it. Like, I understand, like, the ultimate chaos item and, you know, blah, blah, blah. But I can't help but feel this is the result of us getting so many items that the game is like, I don't know how to process all of these items. Like, you have all of the items, which is not true because we don't actually have all the items. But you know what I mean, though? Like, you know, TM Trainer led us to get a Genesis, which procced and then gave us every single item in the game, pretty much. You know, by the mercy of my free will, I stopped taking items. Because we could have just gone on forever, it seems like. So until TM Trainer is guaranteed not to crash the game, I think it should be removed. You might be saying, it's like, well, TM Trainer didn't give you all the items. It just gave you Genesis. It's like, yeah, but the thing is that Genesis feeds off of the amount of items that you have during a run. And we had TM Trainer, and apparently it just gave us infinite items. I'm not sure. So who knows? Just chalk it up to repentance being repentance, I think. But we do have a ton of damage. Let's see if we can get through all these fights without crashing the game. Maybe us being Guppy is also kind of a factor here. All right, let's go after old Beastie. Yep. So if you look, so like we can see the bones kind of fracturing off of Famine right there. That is from compound fracture. So that's another item to never take if you care about your game not crashing over and over and over again. So when compound fracture is proccing, that is when it's crashing the game. Because it's proccing into, I think, what looked like either Eye of Belial or Deadeye, whichever one we have. So basically, anything that fractures is bad. Jacob's Ladder does the same thing. Cricket's Body does the same thing. Amalacria sometimes does the same thing with Tech Zero. So I think what we're going to have to do, instead of just firing, we're just going to have to do contact damage. And use the straw. Okay, yep, that was normal. Oh my god. Okay. That was explosive. I'm just going to stand here. If you guys run into me, it's your own fault. Literally not going to move. Apologies for all the silliness, but I mean, what can we really do about it? But you know, hey, there's win number 100 on the streak. Thank you all very much for the support. It's great to see triple digits back there. And yeah, I'm super happy to be back on the computer. Hopefully all the technical issues outside of Isaac, of course, are fixed. Hope you had a great start to your Tuesday, everyone. Thank you again very much for being a part of the Mosh Pit. And like I said at the beginning of this video, go check out our Synvicta Gaming channel, where I am playing through Diablo 2 Resurrection, even though I haven't recorded for the last couple of days because of obvious reasons I didn't have the computer. I will be putting out more episodes. And thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like RickRue59, McMannon, Glenn McKenzie, Medic Wolf, Squeegee, and Daniel Molinar III. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Synvicta.